no matter what you're going through. I know that you can stand, for your life is in His hand.
Poindexter, pastor of the Love of Christ Bible Way Church, and I just want to say that Sister Juliet Rowland is one of the most beautiful saints that I've known. She's been a pillar in the body of Christ, and she's been a blessing to me and to my wife, Pastor Poindexter, and we really going to miss her. We know how our humanity is going to miss her, but we realize and know that she prepared for this day, and we say to the family, we love you. And our prayers are with you.
This is Sister Corliss James, one of Juliet's good friends. That's my girl. She eat anything that I cook, and she always was coming over my house. I loved her. We share hotel rooms together. There's one thing I can say, she knew the Lord. I got to learn the Lord through her.
Hey, my name is Maury. I'm Edisu's brother, Kevin's brother-in-law, and I just want to thank God for Mother Juliet when she was here. You know, she was an angel on earth. And so therefore, I know she's an angel in heaven now.
Hey, Kevin, this and Shauna and your whole family. This is Harold.
And Nora and Ariel.
Hey, Lula.
That's not.
I'm Yola. I'm Shauna. I'm Kevin.
That's Juliet. Daycare? She used to keep them. And for us, and they all are familiar with Juliet. If she was here right now, they'd be like, Miss Juju.
Hi, I'm Camille, and this is Katina. I'm back again. Can't say bye, you know. I'm just here. First of all, I thank God for the opportunity that He has given me to get to know Sister Juliet. And one of the funniest memories I have of her is we were at the house, and of course the kids were being the kids, and I think Amor was going through her little tantrum, and everywhere she goes, she said, help a Lord, help a Lord. She just whipped out her hand and said, help a Lord, help a Lord. So I thought that was so funny, and I actually went home, and every time my daughter would do something, I said, help a Lord, help a Lord. So, and I have actually had my sister saying that and my mom saying that. She's help the Lord. So I thank God for that.
I am Minister Lorraine M. Lee on behalf of the Lee family. As the Bible said, earth has no sorrows that heaven cannot hear. I thank God for having the opportunity to know Sister Juliet for the past 10 years, and she has been a joy and an inspiration to me. We will forever love you, and we will always keep you as part of our life. God bless you.
To the family, just stay strong, trust in God, and to Kevin, you have an angel that will always be watching over you and the family. And be blessed in Jesus' name, amen.
I got a witness in here somewhere. I know.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Let's give the Lord a round of praise. Well, and praise. Hallelujah. To the family, we're certainly praying for you, and we want you to know that it is not over. It is not finished. It's just the beginning. She's in the hands of the Lord. Our scripture reading, 1 Corinthians 15. Beginning at verse number 50.
Amen. We thank God for His word today. Thank you, Jesus. This time, United Voices of Redfield Choir. God bless us.
Power, power, time. place as we celebrate the homegoing of Sister Juliet Rowland, who's been a beautiful saint of God, one of inspiration, a prayer warrior, one that loved the Lord. Hallelujah. And you being here, amen, show forth manifest, amen. She has touched the lives of many. Surely we honor these dynamic ministers of God and all of the clergy, everybody, amen, praise God. And we surely honor her son, Brother Kevin, and Sister Shauna, and to Julianne, and to Sharon, and all of the family. We love you, and we love her. And we know, as the man of God said when he was up here, we're here to celebrate. We're here to celebrate the life. Amen. Sister Juliet, she realized that this assignment on earth was a temporary one.
Oh, yeah.
She was born into this temporary assignment, but the most important thing, she was born again. And when you were born again, you transitioned from this natural life to eternal life. She's with the Lord now. We are here to say goodbye on this side. Hallelujah. But the host of heaven, I say, welcome home by good and faithful servant. Hallelujah, God. Enter into the joy of the Lord. God bless you.
Is there anyone here from your family who would like to get words?
Praise the Lord, everyone. Poem three. Yes, you have touched our lives in many ways. Now you are abiding in his glorious rays. You are a strong force to be reckoned with, and your faith in God did not shift. In his heavenly arms you now rejoice, praising him with your powerful voice. His praises you always lifted up. That's how we know you're drinking from his heavenly cup.
Come on the house and say, hallelujah! And you know, she was always so funny. You know, I'm crying because I love her so much. I'm kind of jealous of her. She beat me there, amen. You know, but I know she shouted and she was rejoicing before the Lord. I know the Lord allowed her to see this service, and I know she's happy. You know, to the family, we encourage you. You know, she was a jewel to this church. She didn't have a lot of money, but she was rich.
Quite personal. Check her home oftentimes after church, and I can honestly say those are the most entertaining rides I have ever had in my life. And the thing about it was that she didn't, most time, you know, I knew she would ask for a ride while we were in church, but she wouldn't ask me. She would just tell me, take me home. And so you say yes or okay. But you couldn't resist saying no, no matter, you know, I kind of lived in a different side of the world, but it was an honor to take Julia home. She was just a joy to be around. She was a wonderful, wonderful woman. And her conversations were nothing about God. She didn't talk about foolishness. She wasn't here to talk about anybody, but she was talking about the Lord and the Lord only. And so I definitely cherish the time I had to spend with her. She was a joy to be around. You know, most people, you can't say they're a joy to be around. But she was a true joy to be around, no matter how you felt coming into church, just being around her. And as Miss Gina said, she'd be in the corner singing, hallelujah! Yeah. And she had a trademark on that hallelujah. Yeah. But we thank God for her. I just can't wait to the day that when God calls us all home, I'm sure she'll be the first one saying, hallelujah!
But I want to say, too, number one thing Sister Juliet did, and one day she made me some barbecue. And she said, Pastor, I want you to try my new barbecue that I made. I said, okay. Because, and I was hungry when I went home. I said, well, at least I don't have to buy anything to eat. Got home and pulled out the bread, and they got me some slaw, and something said, you got to taste that barbecue first. And when I put a fork in my mouth, I had to spit out real quick. It burnt my mouth to pieces. And when I got back to church the next day, I said, Sister Juliet, did I do anything to offend you? I'm sorry. Praise the Lord, buddy. You know, she said, Pastor, you didn't eat my barbecue. I said, I didn't even swallow it.
Praise the Lord, but you know what is. He said, I'm going to put a cross on my back. I'm going to walk to the top of the hill. The anthropologists, they've been digging everywhere else. They should have followed me to Calvary and watched me die. They should have watched me when they were whipping me all on my back while the blood was streaming down my legs. They should have watched him put nails in my hand and in my feet.
Storm is over now.